past week, you may have noticed smoky evenings around Calgary. This is due to prescribed fires in the Spray Valley. Sustainable Resources Development Alberta and Banff National Park crews are on site managing the fires.
What you're seeing behind me is the Mount Nestor prescribed fire. It's approximately a 9,000 hectare burn, which straddles both Spray Lake Provincial Park and Banff National Park.
These fires are ignited by using a fuel gel mixture, which is airdropped over targeted areas of the forest, specifically mountain pine beetle ravaged trees. Within minutes, flames erupt and burn years of ground fuel comprising of overgrown dead brush and pine beetle affected trees.
However, we have been burning at this site over the last couple of years, usually in very small chunks. The 9,000 hectares won't go up in one fell swoop. It takes several attempts, and we basically burn when the weather allows us to burn. So as those windows open up, we come out, we'll conduct some burning operations, and usually Mother Nature shuts us down after a few days.
A lot of planning goes into a prescribed burn.
Before we start any burning operations in the primary burn unit, what we do is we make sure that we have very solid containment lines around the fire. So those can be natural. For example, behind me, at the top of the peaks, we run into rocks, so there's nothing left to burn. And then on the sides, we use natural barriers wherever we can, like waterfalls, streams, or rock outcroppings. Or if we have to, we'll come in and we'll actually thin out some trees so that it won't sustain a crown fire.
You might wonder, why would anyone want to burn a seemingly healthy forest?
Where we're burning, those trees are in excess of 100 years old, some of them. So this is starting to become an older growth forest. And that's why it's become more susceptible to things like the mountain pine beetle, and one of the reasons that we're in here conducting this type of burn. We're going to achieve three things with the Mount Nestor burn. First, we're going to help restore a healthy and natural balance to an aging forest. Second, we're going to remove a prime pocket of mountain pine beetle habitat. And third, it's going to open up the area, make it a lot more suitable for species like elk. It allows us to reintroduce fire on the landscape in a way that's controlled, as opposed to the alternative, which is nature-caused wildfires, which usually happen at very inopportune times and are very difficult to control. So if we can come in out here and burn in a controlled way, in a controlled manner, it helps us achieve the benefits of fire, but in a way that's not going to threaten homes and communities.
As you can imagine, a fire of this size attracts a lot of attention. There have been people stopping by to watch.
Well, we're asking people to observe all of the trail closures that are in place. It's not safe to be going in the backcountry where these burn operations are happening. So that's number one, first and foremost. We want to ensure public safety, and that's why those trails have been closed. However, there are some good viewing points along the way. So if you do want to come out and take a look and see what's happening, by all means, you can stop by, talk with some of the staff, learn a little bit more about prescribed fires and the benefits that we see from them here in Alberta.
The Mount Nestor prescribed fire will continue operations perhaps into October, and as a result, we may have a few more spectacular sunsets in the days to come. Francois Arsenault, Shaw TV, near Canmore, Alberta.